Hey, welcome back to the channel, guys. I hope you're all doing well. I know this is kind of a tough time for everyone around the world, and a lot of people are at home. I've got this mess of a setup behind me, all these monitors, if you look closely. I've got a Windows laptop that I switch between, a Mac laptop, and I'm just trying to work on all these different screens and still create content for Pacers Gaming, the YouTube channel and esports team that I work for. Now, I wanted to create a video because I know everyone's got a lot of time at home, and whether or not you are in school, out of school, want to learn graphic design, or just interested in getting to know more about it, I thought I'd create and compile a list of resources for you guys to get started with graphic design learning at home. So first off, if you don't even know, this is Pixel and Bracket YouTube channel. I create a ton of videos around learning graphic design, especially tutorials, whether it's Illustrator, Photoshop, Premiere, After Effects, any of the Adobe programs. So you can check this channel out for plenty of videos on all those creative programs. And I also, if you don't know, if you're already subbed and you kind of already know this, but you don't know, I do have two free courses over on Skillshare, one about Photoshop and one about Illustrator. These are like what I would teach for any beginner that wants to learn Illustrator, learn Photoshop, and hasn't ever even touched the program. And it's also everything that I would recommend to a seasoned designer if they don't already know. So those are free. You can sign up with just an email, but I've got something even better. If you guys go to the link in the description, I can get you 2 free months of Skillshare Premium. So even if it's not graphic design, which there are tons of other premium courses on Skillshare that you can watch and learn from, there are also all sorts of online learning opportunities over on Skillshare. Now, this video isn't sponsored, but because I'm a teacher on Skillshare, I can offer that link. I get a referral so you guys can help this channel out, and you guys get 2 free months of all premium courses on Skillshare, which is pretty awesome no matter what you want to learn with your time here at home. So that's enough about me. What I would recommend you start out with is there's a playlist I created called, well, it's called Learning Graphic Design, but it's got videos from gcflearnfree.org. And that's a YouTube channel that has a ton of great resources for educational things. It's not just graphic design, but they have some amazing graphic design videos that they've created over there, and I put them in a playlist, and I think you should watch every single second of those videos. There's an intro to design, there's color, typography, branding, all sorts of things. Layout and composition, I think, is one of the best videos. I even have that tweet pinned to the top of the Pixel and Bracket Twitter. Regardless, that's a great playlist. I'll link that in the description, as with anything else in this video. Another site that has an article for 20 free graphic design resources for learning design is Creative Block. And Creative Block is a great website in general. You can go over there and find all sorts of things. But this article that I linked has 20 different resources for learning more of like the hard skills and the lingo and terminology of design and typography, as well as maybe just creating a poster, creating a brochure, anything like that. And as you're diving into the skill sets of graphic design, if you want to freelance or you want to learn more about the business side of design and how to create potentially a portfolio, how to charge clients, how to learn more about how to interact in those sort of one-on-one situations where you're emailing potential clients or you're trying to look for people to do design work for, I would recommend The Future. It's a great channel over there with Chris Doe and the crew. They are creating an amazing library of content that is super helpful, all about the business of design. And they also, I think, have The Future Academy, which is even more tutorial focused stuff. So tons of great content over there. I'll link that YouTube channel in the description. I highly, highly recommend it, especially if you're already a designer and you're just looking to get some more freelance work or for ways that you can essentially monetize this career path that you've chosen. And then lastly, on the practical side of things, one of my biggest recommendations is that you guys go out there. If you want to learn design, you're like, I can take all these tutorials, but I don't feel like I'm really learning how to do things. What I would recommend is find work that inspires you, that you think is really great, and you're like, man, I wish I could make something like that. And what I would do is try to copy that exactly. Learn the spacing between the letters, learn the layout, the hierarchy of all the elements, how sort of, you know, that black and white image really pops. Maybe it's adding some more contrast, maybe it's adding a little bit more detail to it through an unsharp mask or some kind of sharpening. I would look at work that you're inspired by and literally try to go recreate it. If you're looking for assets for design like photography, or if you're doing video work, even some video resources, I would recommend, I think, Pexels and Unsplash.com. I'll link those below as well. Lots of stuff in the description in this video, you guys. So you can pull images copyright free from there. But actually, it doesn't really even matter in this case, because what I'm telling you to do is to create this stuff, but not necessarily promote it, publish it, put it in your portfolio. You're literally just creating something, copying the work of people that inspire you, other designers that inspire you, other work from brands or anything that you really enjoy and want to learn how to get onto that level. Literally copy it. Copy it, and you're going to learn so much from it. Whether you're working in Photoshop, whether you're working in Illustrator, all the different techniques that you're gonna figure out on how to create those designs are gonna really, really, really help you when you're trying to create work for your portfolio. And speaking of your portfolio, if you're wanting to build up, whether it's an online digital portfolio, which I would recommend anyway, or something that you're gonna print out and take into a job interview, create work for that portfolio that is what you want to do. There's all sorts of design out there in the world. There's all sorts of types, styles, everything. Create work that you want to do, and then take that to companies that you want to work for. And what I would recommend in that work is that you try to make it as practical as possible. So if it's not real client work, if it's not even student work, if you're just creating these projects on your own, like just creating a sample brochure, I would find a brochure, find a flyer, find a piece of design, a business card, anything out there, and pull all of those elements from it and make sure you include them all into your sample work that you're putting into your portfolio. That'll make it look even more real. Don't just try to come up with the information in your head on your own, because you're gonna miss out on some elements that make it look like student work, look like just sort of sample mock-up designs. You're gonna wanna include everything that you find, even the fine print, the little details, put it into that sort of spec mock-up work, and it's gonna make it look a lot better. And then create that portfolio of work of 3 to 5 really strong pieces of design. Put them in a place that's easy for people to find. So whether it's Behance, or you have your own website, or you just upload them to maybe even an Instagram just to show off your gallery of, I guess, your portfolio. Make it easy. Send that link to the people. Write a nice cover letter. Have a good resume if you're looking for work after this is all over, or if you're watching this video 3 years later and you know, there is no pandemic anymore, go through all of these resources. I hope they really help you out. Create your portfolio, work on your skills, and you're gonna learn a lot more about graphic design very, very quickly. I hope this video helped you guys out. I don't know if I rambled on too much. We'll kind of find out in the edit, but I'm Spencer from Pixel and Bracket. I hope you guys stay safe while you're all kind of bunkered in. We're all quarantined at home. And of course, have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time.